In this video, you will be able to see how you can reduce your own contribution to climate change by reducing the amount of carbon dioxide you are responsible for releasing into the atmosphere. Imagine someone living in a warm place in a house built of wood, mud and straw, who cooks using firewood with an ox to plough the land, and who grows all their own food and all the food their animals need. Would they be adding extra carbon dioxide to the atmosphere? Pause and think. The answer is no. Everything they use and grow is part of the natural carbon cycle, where carbon dioxide is captured during photosynthesis and released again when living things respire or when the wood burns. This person could be somebody living before we started using fossil fuels, or maybe living in a village remote from centres of industry. They have a carbon footprint of zero. Your carbon footprint is measured by the amount of extra carbon dioxide your lifestyle adds to the atmosphere as a result of the use of fossil fuels or the cutting down of trees, etc. The world average is about 4 tons per person per year, but that hides a huge difference. The USA is about 20, Europe around 10, and India about 1, although within these countries there's also a huge range. For people living in the developed, affluent world, the 10 tons is made up of using a car, flying by air, heating and electricity in the home, clothes and food, leisure activities, and buildings, manufacture and public services generally. Of course, if your country generates electricity without burning fossil fuel, for example nuclear power or replenishables such as wind or hydro, your carbon footprint will be reduced. Can you think of ways you might reduce your own personal carbon footprint? Pause the video whilst you think. Well, you had to think of ways to reduce your use of fossil fuels. You might use energy to heat your home or cool it down. So, put at least 40 centimetres of insulation made of mineral wool or similar in the attic. Have large windows facing the midday sun and small ones opposite. Fit triple-glazing, now standard for new homes in Canada and Scandinavia. Insulate the walls of your house well. In hot climates, build verandas or have a central courtyard, as in ancient Rome or the Medinas of Morocco, with natural cooling. You avoid the need to use air conditioning or fans. You might need to travel. If you have to use a car, reduce your speed. Most of the car's energy is used to push air out of the way. Better still, try to use buses and trains, and for short journeys, walk or cycle or take the bullock cart. You need to eat, and growing and processing your food and bringing it to your house may have used fuel. If you cannot grow your own food, try to buy it locally to save transport costs. However, the main use of fossil fuels in agriculture is on the farm. For example, dairy and sheep meat production for the UK is more energy efficient if grown in New Zealand, even including the transport costs, because fertilisers are not needed in New Zealand, where sheep graze on hillsides unsuitable for human crops. Maybe the biggest way to reduce your carbon footprint is not to eat meat, especially red meat. By growing food for ourselves rather than for animals which we later eat, we can get up to 10 times as much food from the same land and fertilizer use. You may use electricity in the home. For example, what percentage of the electrical energy used by a filament light bulb comes out as useful light? Pause and think. Well, most of the energy comes out as waste heat and less than 3% as light. So replace your filament light bulbs with new LED lights, which are nearly 100% efficient. If you use a dishwasher or washing machine, make sure they're full and on low temperature setting and have a low water usage. Finally, recycle unwanted materials. Although it costs energy to transport and reprocess the waste, it uses less energy than starting with fresh raw materials.